6 days to recount almost 5 million ballots by hand. That's the situation in Georgia. The interesting question is, why do it? It seems the only person who gets full satisfaction from this might be the current president. The work is also going to fall on the backs of some exhausted Americans, them being the election workers who are coming off almost a month of marathon shifts. Big effort, paid for with tax dollars, but is it necessary? Nobody expects any of it to matter. The president-elect leads by more than 14,000 votes there. He holds well over 270 electoral votes, even without Georgia. Now, Geoff Duncan is the state's Republican lieutenant governor, and he joins us tonight. Thank you for doing it, sir.
Absolutely. Great to be with you.
Help me understand the state of play. The law there says equal to or less than 0.5% of a percentage point, a candidate can ask for an audit. And then it is done by the machines recounting, or you can have a select audit where you sample individual ballots from different areas just to spot check. You instead are doing a full recount by hand. Why?
Well, our state's right in the middle of the process, like every other state right now, counting every legal ballot out there. We've got 159 counties, and obviously the state's working with each and every one of them. Our Secretary of State, it's actually two processes, Chris. There's the process of the audit, which is a risk audit. And the Secretary of State made the decision to audit the presidential race. And based on the numbers and the algorithms and whatnot, they decided to audit the entire 5 million votes. Then separate from that is the candidates are able to ask for a recount. And so that would be a separate process. In the midst of it, I think the Secretary of State stated today that the risk audit would start on Friday and end on Wednesday. And certainly, you know, I see it as an advantage for us. We're going to be able to gain the confidence of 11 million Georgians and nearly 5 million people who voted in the recent election.
Governor, do you have a reason? And I know it's Lieutenant Governor, but I was raised by a Lieutenant Governor.
You call me
Governor,
Geoff.
And no. I respect the title. Lieutenant Governor and Governor are both Governor. That's why I say it. Governor, do you have any reason to believe that the count is off?
Well, we continue to work very closely with our Attorney General, Chris Carr, with our Secretary of State's office, Brad Raffensperger. They have all the resources ready and available to investigate. Certainly, they're continuing to field some calls. There's some things out there. I think we've heard some early reports about potentially some deceased individuals and certainly some issues out there, and they continue to investigate those. At this time, I've not seen any sort of systemic irregularities or any sort of systemic issues, but there's still time, and certainly this audit is out there to make sure that they don't exist.
Right.
Because at the end of the day, look, this is a bipartisan goal here for all of us. We want this election to be fair and legal, and every legal vote to be counted. And certainly, we all champion that process here in Georgia.
Right, but usually you're not waiting for proof of a problem. You're acting if there is proof of a problem, which you say you haven't seen any substantial or systemic issue here, and yet you're doing a full recount, which isn't even called for by law. It seems like you're going an extra mile to make somebody happy. Is that a wrong assertion?
Yeah, I think it is. The law actually calls for a risk audit, and they've all gotten in the room together.
But a risk audit isn't the entire count. Am I correct?
Well, actually, the risk audit is described to me would require, because of the statistical closeness of the race, would require several million. And so it would take so much time to pull out several million votes, as opposed to just being able to go through the 6 day period of time and count the full 5 million. So I believe other folks much smarter than me have decided that that was the best way, most efficient way forward to take the risk audit.
So a risk limiting audit winds up being the same thing as a full recount, even though in the state law it describes it as a partial process, just to kind of take the temperature of what's out there, you know, a sampling as opposed to a full recount.
Well, I believe the secondary process is a candidate is allowed to ask
that's a
for
machine
that recount,
recount
because of the half. That's correct. So, look, we've got a lot of opportunities here to earn the confidence of Georgians, and certainly we're going to be proud of our effort as we put forward.
If Biden had said, "I think I won by more, I want you to recount all the votes," would you have done it?
Yeah, look, I think that he has that legal right. Chris, just because the guy I voted for isn't ahead right now doesn't mean my job description changes, right? Mm-hmm. And so my job is to go to work every day and follow the letter of the law. And certainly that's what I'm going to take seriously. And I know that our Secretary of State, Attorney General, and our election offices are doing exactly that. It is absolutely imperative for us to earn the confidence of our Georgian voters and also the candidates. Anybody who's put their name on the ballot deserves the right to have every legal vote counted. And that's the process we're right in the middle of doing right now.
How do you feel about what's happening? Do you believe that Joe Biden is the president-elect?
Look, I think those terms are left with the media. My job is to count the votes and to make sure we certify a fair legal election here in Georgia. And to make it even more complicated, I heard you mentioned on the lead-in, was, you know, we also have the balance of the Senate is sitting here in
right.
Georgia. And so, you know, look, we obviously a lot going on here. And certainly I want to make sure, as a Republican, I want to make sure I focus hard on trying to get David Perdue and Kelly Loeffler back into the Senate.
They called for the Secretary of State to step down because they didn't like that the election was the way it was. You agree with that?
Yeah. Well, I haven't talked to them yet. I've worked very closely with the Secretary of State's office. He's been great to work with at this point. Their team
so
has communicated very well to us. Well, certainly I haven't seen any challenges on my end. And he's made it very clear he's not stepping down.
Yep.
So I think he's taking care of that point.
Just one other thing, Governor, and I appreciate your time. You do know that president-elect is not a media creation. It is not a term that we use. It is a term of art within our constitutional democracy. You know that, right? That president-elect matters.
Look, I'll let you take that term. At this point, I'm going to focus on the election. But Chris, I will
tell
you this.
So you don't use the term president-elect? I feel like you're ducking the question.
Will.
I don't know why.
No. So if you let me answer, Chris.
Go ahead.
I'll tell you this. When we see our certification here in Georgia and when we watch the other states certify, I'll be proud to call whoever is out there president-elect because that's what America has voted for. And certainly we still have a process to work forward.
Did you wait in 2016 when Trump won, or did you call him president-elect before the certification?
I can't remember back that far. That's 2016.
Really? You're a young man. You should be able to remember that far.
I think
a lot has changed since 2016.
I didn't get elected until 2018.
But I'll give you that much. A lot has changed since then. Lieutenant Governor, I appreciate your candor. I don't mean to be cute. Thank you. This is a very serious situation. And I appreciate you doing it. Lieutenant Governor Geoff Duncan, good luck to you there. I hope everything is accurate and to everyone's satisfaction.
Thank you.
Be well.